Hello guys! Welcome sa ating Z-Knowledge TV.
Okay, so sa ating next video, under the Mathematics in the Modern World, so ating pag-aaralan, yung ating next lesson na tinatawag nating Credit Cards and Consumer Loans.
So, lahat ng ito ay pag-aaralan natin dito sa ating tutorial. Pero, before tayo mag-start, don't forget to like this video and click the subscribe button para ma-notify kayo sa mga next videos. So, let's get started.
Okay, so ano ba itong consumer loans? So, a consumer loan is a loan given to consumers to finance specific types of expenditures. In other words, a consumer loan is any type of a loan made to a consumer by a creditor. So, the loan can be secured or backed by the assets of the borrower or unsecured or not backed by the assets of the borrower. So, ibig sabihin, consumer loan, ito yung mga different loans na pwede natin gamitin para makapambili tayo ng mga pangailangan natin. Okay, so meron nga tayong loan na secured at meron din tayong loan na unsecured. Okay, so borrowed money can be used for many purposes, from funding a new business to buying your fiancé an engagement ring. But with all of the different types of loans out there, which is best and for which purpose? So below are the most common types of loan and how they work. So meron tayong tinatawag na personal loans and credit cards with high interest rates but do not require collateral. So pag sabing collateral, ito yung may kapalit kapag hindi mo nabayaran yung loan natin. Okay? So home equity loans have low interest rates but the borrower's home serves as collateral. Okay? So ibig sabihin naman ito, kapag hindi mo naman nabayaran yung bahay na niloan mo, so mismong bahay yung possible na maging collateral niya. Okay? So next, cash advances typically have very high interest rates plus transaction. So, ito yung ilan sa consumer loans na pwede natin ma-avail. Okay? So, next. So, meron pa tayong different types of consumer loans. Ayan. So, ito yung different types. So, meron tayong tatawag na mortgage. So, a mortgage is a loan provided by a mortgage lender or a bank that enables an individual to purchase a home or property. While it's possible to take out loans to cover the entire cost of a home, it's more common to secure a loan for about 80% of the home's value. So, for more details ng mortgage, so kung paano ba ito kompeten, is panoorin nyo yung video natin about home ownership. Okay? So next, a credit card is a loan used by consumers to finance everyday purchases. So ito naman yung tinakal natin sa previous video natin, sa part 1, okay? Then next, auto loan is a loan used by consumers to finance the purchase of a vehicle. So ito naman is kapag bibili ka ng sasakyan pero wala kang cash, so pwede kang mag-auto loan. Okay, so itong auto loan, pwede itong i-avail sa mga banko or sa mga kung anumang finance association or institute. Okay? So, a student loan is a loan used by consumers to finance education. Ito naman is pautangin yung mga estudyante para makapagpatuloy sa pag-aaral. And then, yung pagbabayad naman ito is kapag nakagraduate na sila at nakahanap na lang sarili nilang trabaho. Okay? So next, refinancing a loan allows a borrower to replace their current debt obligation with one that has more favorable terms. Ito naman is kapag may currently ka pang utang, pero gusto mo na ulit umutang, so ang gagawin, yung panibago mong utang is babayaran niya yung dati mong utang. And then yung matitira is ayun yung pwede mong gamitin as personal. Okay? Then, a home equity loan, also known as an equity loan, home equity installment loan, or a second mortgage, is a type of consumer debt. Home equity loans allow homeowners to borrow against the equity in their homes The loan amount is based on the difference between the home current market value and the homeowner's mortgage balance due. Ito naman is kapag kailangan mo ng pang-equity, so pwede mong gamitin itong home equity loan. Okay? So, yung details din ng home equity is matutunan nyo rin sa video natin sa home ownership. Okay? And then last, yung personal loan is a loan used by consumers for a personal purposes. So, ito yung pwede yung gamitin sa kahit ano. So, pwedeng pang outing, pang bili ng ring ng yung fiancé, and kung ano pa man. Okay? So, ito yung personal loan. So, next, calculating monthly payments. So, the stated interest rate for most consumer loans, such as a car loan, is normally the annual percentage rate or APR as required by the Truth in Lending Act. The payment amount for these loans given by the following formula. So, payment formula for an APR loan. The payment for a loan based on the APR is given by this formula na M is equal to A times I divided by 1 minus 1 plus I raised to negative N. Where M is the payment, A is the loan amount, I is the interest rate per payment period, and N is the total number of payments. So, it is important to note that in this formula, I is the interest rate per payment period. So, for instance, if the annual interest rate is 9% and payments are made monthly, then annual interest rate divided by number of payments per year. So, ito yung same na tinakil natin o pinag-aralan natin dun sa previous video natin na compound interest. So, itong annual interest rate, ito yung nominal interest rate natin, which is ito yung J. Then, itong number of payments per year, ito yung compound frequency natin, which is ito yung M. So, 0.09 divided by 12, so makakuha tayo ng I na 0.0075. So, itong 0.0075 na ito, ang gagamitin natin dito sa ating formula. Okay? At hindi itong 9% na ito. So, next. So, proceed tayo sa example 3. SM Appliances Store is offering anyone who purchases a television an annual interest rate of 9.5% for 4 years. If Games purchases a 50-inch rear projection television for 5,895 pesos from SM Appliances Store, find his monthly payment. So given, so meron tayong annual interest rate na 9.5% or 0.095. So again, ito yung nominal interest rate natin. So ito yung J natin. Then N is equal to 4 times 12 na 48. So bakit? Kasi itong 4 na to is ito yung years natin, ito yung T. Then itong 12 natin is ito yung M o yung compounding frequency natin. So therefore makakuha tayo ng period na 48. So yung A natin is 5,895 pesos or ito yung parang principal. Okay? So, using this formula ng I, so J over M lang to. Okay, wherein yung J natin is 0.095 at yung M natin is 12 months. Okay, kasi monthly payment tayo. So, therefore, 0.095 divided by 12 is 0.007917. So, using this formula ng ating monthly payment. So, sabihin natin mga given natin. So, makakuha tayo ng M na 150 pesos and 61 centavos. So, ito yung magiging monthly payment natin. So, calculating loan payoff. So, sometimes a consumer wants to pay off a loan before the end of the loan term. For instance, suppose you have a 5-year car loan but would like to purchase a new car after owning your car for 4 years. Because there is still 1 year remaining on the loan, you must pay off the remaining loan before purchasing another car. So this is not as simple as just multiplying a monthly car payment by 12 to arrive at the payoff amount. So the reason, as we mentioned earlier, is that each payment includes both interest, and principal. So kaya naman, by solving the payment formula for an APR loan for A, the amount of the loan, we can calculate the payoff amount, which is just the remaining principal. So ito yung formula ng ating APR. So A is equal to M times 1 minus 1 plus I raised to negative N over I. Okay? So nag-come up din yan dun sa formula natin ng ating monthly payment na M is equal to A times I over 1 minus 1 plus I raised to negative N. Okay? So ginawa lang dyan, dinivide lang nila yan both side by I over 1 minus 1 plus I raised to negative N both side. Okay, para makancel to. So, para maiwan nag-iisa yung A sa side na to. Okay, so, nangyari, A is equal to M divided by, so, magiging reciprocal tong dalawang to, itong part na to. Okay, so, magiging M times 1 minus 1 plus I raised to negative N over I. Okay, kasi pag nag-divide tayo ng fraction, let's say 2 divided by 1 third. So, ginagawa natin dyan is yung 2, nire-resume natin. So, times, ginagawa natin times na kasi from division, magiging multiplication na. Tapos yung itong nasa denominator natin is mag-reciprocate yan. So, magiging 3 over 1. Okay, so ganun lang nangyari dito. So, kaya naman, yung A natin is M times 1 minus 1 plus I raised to negative N over I. So, ito na yun. Okay? So, where M is the payment, A is the loan payoff, I is the interest rate per payment period, and N is the number of remaining payments. So, for example 4, Peter wants to pay off the loan on his jet ski that he has owned for 18 months. His monthly payment is 284 pesos and 67 centavos on a 2-year loan at an annual percentage rate of 8.7%. Find the payoff amount. So given, so meron tayong M na 284 pesos and 67 centavos. So annual interest rate na 8.7% or 0.087. Again, ito yung J. And then, meron tayong N na 24 minus 18. Bakit naging ganito yung formula natin? Kasi meron tayong 24 months na need bayaran. Okay, kasi 2-year loan yung meron tayo. Tapos, nakapagbayad na tayo ng 18 months. So, itong 2 years, convert natin sa months. So, magiging year yung sa baba para makancel itong year natin. At yung sa taas is yung kung ano yung i-convert natin. So, since na year to month tayo, so therefore, month yung nasa taas natin. So, meron tayong 12 months in 1 year. So, cancel na yung year. So, 2 times 12 is 24 months. And then, may na-avail tayong 18. So, yung minus natin yun. So, therefore, matitirahan na lang tayo ng 6 months. Okay, then yung 6 months na yan, ayan yung N natin. Okay, so next, using this formula ng I, so again, J over M lang din to. So therefore, substitute natin yung mga given natin, so makakuha tayo ng I na 0.00725. Then using this formula ng A, o ng payoff natin, so substitute natin yung mga given natin, so makakuha tayo ng A na 1,665 pesos and 50 centavos. Okay, so ito yung payoff natin. So, next. Car leases. So, leasing a car may result in lower monthly car payments. So, the primary reason for this is that at the end of the lease term, you do not own the car. Ownership of the car reverts to the dealer, who can then sell it as a used car and realize the profit from the sale. So, ito naman is kapag imbis na bibili kang sarili mong sasakyan, pero since wala kang pera, ganun kalaking pera, so maglilis ka na lang. Okay, so dito, masasabi natin, so kung ano yung kinaibahan ng pag nag-lease ka ng car or kapag bumili ka mismo ng car. So the value of the car at the end of the lease term is called the residual value of the car. So the residual value of a car is frequently based on a percent of the manufacturer's suggested retail price and normally varies between 40% and 60% of the MSRP, depending on the type of lease. So for instance, suppose the MSRP of a car is 18,500 pesos and the residual value is 45% of the MSRP, then kunin natin yung 45% ng 18,500. So pag multiply natin yun, sumakot tayo ng residual value na 8,325 pesos. So the residual value is 8,325 pesos. This is the amount that the dealer thinks the car will be worth at the end of the lease period. So the person leasing the car, the lessee, usually has the option of purchasing the car at the price at the end of the lease. So ibig sabihin, itong 8,325 pesos na to, ito yung gagamitin ng dealer kung pwede niya ba ibenta ng tuluyan dun sa lessee. Okay? So at the end of the lease term. So in addition to the residual value of the car, the monthly lease payment for a car takes into consideration net capitalized cost, the money factor, average monthly finance charge, and average monthly depreciation. Each of these terms is defined below. So, ito yung mga different formulas natin. So, net capitalized cost is equal to negotiated price minus down payment minus trade-in value. Money factor is equal to annual interest rate as percent divided by 2,400. Average monthly finance charge is equal to net capitalized cost plus residual value times money factor. Average monthly depreciation is equal to net capitalized cost minus residual value divided by terms of the lease in months. Okay, so kaya tayo may ganitong formula na depreciation kasi lahat ng bagay is nagde-depreciate or nawawalan ng halaga. Okay, so monthly lease payment formula. So the monthly lease payment formula is given by P is equal to F plus D, where P is the monthly lease payment, F is the average monthly finance charge, and D is the average monthly depreciation of the car. Okay, so proceed tayo sa example 5 para maunawa natin kung para saan ba yung mga formula ngayon. So the director of a human resources for a company decides to lease a car for 30 months. Suppose the annual interest rate is 8.4%, the negotiated price is 29,500 pesos. There is no trade-in, and the down payment is 5,000 pesos. So find the monthly lease payment, assume that the residual value is 55% of the MSRP of 33,400 pesos. So meron tayong MSRP na 33,400. Meron tayong residual rate na 55% or 0.55. Meron tayong annual interest rate na 8.4%. Meron tayong terms of the lease na 30 months. Meron tayong negotiated price na 29,500. Meron tayong down payment na 5,000 pesos. So, using this formula ng net capitalized cost, so, subset natin yung mga given natin. So, meron tayong 29,500 for negotiated price. Meron tayong down payment na 5,000 and wala tayong trade-in value. Okay? So, walang binigay na trade-in value. Kasi sabi nito, no trade-in. Okay? So, makakuha tayo ng net capitalized cost na 24,500 pesos. Then next, using this formula ng residual value, so makakupit natin ang ating residual na 18,370 pesos. Okay? So, then next, using formula naman ng money factor, so annual interest rate as percent divided by 2,400. So, kaya naman, yung 8.4% to is hindi natin siya kinonvert into decimal kasi kailangan natin is naka-percent. Okay? So, kaya naman, 8.4 mismo yung ilalagay natin dito. Okay? At hindi yung 0.084. Hindi yan. Okay? So, therefore, ang money factor natin is 0.0035. Then, average monthly finance charge. So, ito yung formula. So, substitute natin mga nakuha natin. So, meron tayong net capitalized cost na 24,500, meron tayong residual value na 18,370, at meron tayong money factor na 0.0035. So, makakuha tayo ngayon ng average monthly finance charge na 150 pesos and 5 centavos. So, then using this formula na average monthly depreciation, so, meron tayong net capitalized cost na 24,500, residual value na 18,370, at meron tayong terms of the lease na 30 months. Okay, so therefore, ang average monthly depreciation natin is 204 pesos and 33 centavos. So, monthly lease payment, so using this formula, P is equal to F plus D. So, meron tayong F na 150 pesos and 5 centavos at meron tayong D na 204 pesos and 33 centavos. So, kaya naman, ang monthly lease payment natin is 354 pesos and 38 centavos. Okay? So, ito kung paano masolve natin yung ating car leasing. Okay? O yung monthly lease payment natin. Okay? So, dito na nagtatapos yung ating discussion for the topic natin na credit cards and consumer loans. So, maraming salamat.